Hello everyone, I'm Agile T, and as Luisa said, I'm an architect and urban designer coming from Greece and living the last 4 years in the Netherlands. But before I start my presentation, I would like to thank you for the honor to present my observations about public space in Greece during the outbreak of coronavirus. But what can be said about COVID-19 that hasn't been said already? Rather than simply presenting and talking about numbers, about cases and deaths, I would like to share my life experience in my hometown. And probably you don't know it because it's a medium-sized city on the northern part of Greece. It is called Alexandroupolis, and it is an important waterfront port city with around 60,000 people. It has not an official public space, central square, for as many cities have, but it provides people with some open public spaces, with the most important to be along the recently redeveloped waterfront, a big city park in the west of the city, and many streets with cafes and taverns, mainly in the city center and along the waterfront. But coming to the subject of COVID-19, on the 17th of March, BBC News announced the outbreak of coronavirus has led to the emptying of public spaces around the world. All media presented an image of cities to which weren't used, abandoned streets, mass transportation without masses, closed stores, people at home, silence, the so-called ghost cities. We were bombarded with images of metropolitan areas, big famous cities, popular touristic destinations. But what about a medium-sized city in Greece? Returning from the Netherlands to Greece a few days before the big lockdown, I confronted a new Greek reality. The Greek government took strict measures quite fast, and the movement of people was permitted for a prescribed set of essential reasons. Citizens leaving their homes were required to have with them their ID or passport. They had also to send a message or carry a signed attestation in which personal information and the purpose of going out were stated. As the reasons for going out were limited, it was observed a tendency towards the sixth reason: sport, exercise, walking the dog. It is not so common for Greek people to be so physically active, so many images and videos were created during the time, making fun of the sudden turn of Greeks towards sports and their need for a pet. Here, for example, you can see a Greek people during before the coronavirus and during the coronavirus. However, this sudden turn towards working out appeared also in the form of walk and stroll, transforming the whole city in a livable walking route. Every area of the city was full of people, mainly walking, studying, or resting on a bench. Even in not well-known, undefined, or unused places, the presence of people started to be noticeable, with a preference towards local places, and the recently redeveloped waterfront didn't lose its popularity. This period, it was also impossible to find an empty bench. Apart from benches, every element which can be used as a sitting place was also utilized. Pedestrians and cyclists were more much for the cars, and the absence of cars made people to use also the streets in order to walk and to keep the appropriate distances from each other. Cafes, bars, and taverns were closed, so the sidewalks were free for walk, without the coffee tables, umbrellas, and other elements blocking the accessibility and walkability of specific places. The Greek coffee drinking culture was not disappeared though. Many small cafes offered the option of takeaway, and Greek people enjoyed their coffee in public space, socializing with others, but always from distance. Despite the readjustment on the proxemics, it seems that COVID-19 made people more social in public space. They stopped more often to greet each other and discuss from distance. They weren't in a rush, so they did it for longer. Socializing with unknown persons changed as well. Unknown people smiled to each other and exchanged glances of sympathy. However, the changes in street life weren't the same during the whole period. the different kind of measures and the steps towards the normalcy appeared in different times, influencing so the behavior of Greeks in public space and the city life. According to me, three are the important starting dates in which I observed differences in the public city life. The first is the general lockdown and the strict restrictions on all the non-essential movements. During that period, a lot of people were walking in the city alone or in pairs. The weather conditions played an important role on the decision of people to go out or not. Benches were used mainly by old people who sat alone or young people who gathered in groups. The second day is the 4th of May, with a slackening of the rules about going out of home for a reason. That period, more people were in the streets than before. Cyclists made also their appearance. Benches and all the possible sitting places were full of people from different ages. Children started to play again in the playgrounds. The majority of people were in groups of 3 to 5 people. In the end, the last date begins with the gradual reopening of the cultural and recreational amenities. In the beginning, only a few people were in the cafes and taverns. Most of them preferred walking and doing other activities in the city. Gradually, there was a mix of activities with a great preference towards the beaches for swimming. Coming to an end, we all know that for years, much of Europe has looked down on Greece as an insolvable problem, and probably still does. The economic depression that Greece has experienced for more than 10 years and the measures which were implemented since 2008 had many consequences for the country and the citizens. And one of those was, of course, in the health system. But probably the economic crisis made Greece to build community resilience in unexpected and difficult circumstances, like the outbreak of coronavirus. As George Pavoulatos, a political economist, said, Greeks reacted to the lockdown with surprise compliance, a legacy of the economic crisis. Greece has been in almost non-stop crisis mode, so society was better prepared to enter a state of alert. Although the situation in Greece now it is more crucial than before due to the arrival of many tourists, for all its inherent frailties in this pandemic, Greece these times can walk with its head held high and constitute a showcase of community resilience. Thank you.